You're watching a protected PCI.com video.
Hi, I'm Jess, an Advanced Impella Trainer with Abiomed, and welcome to another episode of Abiomed Education. Today we are going to discuss blood compatibility. First, we will define hemolysis. Second, we will review clinical signs and symptoms to diagnose hemolysis. And third, we will review key troubleshooting tips to reduce the risk of hemolysis with Impella heart pumps. Hemolysis is the destruction of red blood cells. A damaged red blood cell can release hemoglobin directly into the bloodstream. Hemolysis can be caused by certain medical conditions, medications, and mechanical damage due to exposure of red blood cells to such things as artificial heart valves, hemodialysis, and mechanical circulatory support devices. If left untreated, hemolysis can lead to acute kidney and liver failure. The least specific indication is blood in the urine. Remember that just because you see a pigment change in the urine, it could be caused by more than hemolysis. A simple urinalysis showing multiple red cells is diagnostic. LDH, or lactic dehydrogenase, can increase due to any type of tissue death and can include red blood cells, platelets, myocardial tissue, and liver tissue damage. Indirect bilirubin. RBC debris is processed in the liver and can cause increases in indirect bilirubin. Haptoglobin levels decline, free hemoglobin is released from the RBC and binds to haptoglobin. The most specific clinical indicator of hemolysis is plasma free hemoglobin. It is a direct measurement of the hemoglobin liberated from the red blood cell in the plasma. Clinically significant hemolysis is defined from the FDA as two plasma-free hemoglobin test results greater than 40 milligrams per deciliter in a 24-hour period. Impella is designed to be blood compatible. As you can see, Impella heart pumps cause less risk of hemolysis than the standard bypass pump used in open heart surgery. And shear forces that Impella places on the red blood cell are well below the shear forces needed to damage a red blood cell. Now let's discuss how to troubleshoot signs of hemolysis. Address and correct any active position or suction alarms as a potential cause of hemolysis. If the urine is red, rule out blood in the urine by getting a simple urinalysis looking for whole red blood cells. Check if there has been a drop in hemoglobin. You can also check if lab samples are hemolyzed. Check the plasma-free hemoglobin. Greater than 40 milligrams per deciliter is clinically significant. And if the plasma-free hemoglobin is not available, you could check the spun plasma color for evidence of suspected hemolysis. Consider giving volume if suspected hemolysis is accompanied by a CVP or a wedge pressure of less than 10 millimeters of mercury. And finally, assess position of the Impella heart pump with echo, looking for inlet or outlet obstructions due to malposition of the device. In summary, Impella pumps have low risk of clinically significant hemolysis when properly positioned and suction alarms are addressed in a timely manner. Thank you for watching this edition of Abiomed Education.
You've been watching a protected PCI.com video.